Hi, I'm Liz. Painting interior trim really ties a room together in any home, especially if you find a color that coordinates with your doors, cabinets, and walls. Painting your trim might sound like tedious work, but a Wagner FLEXiO 3500 sprayer with the detail nozzle will help you get it done with a nice, smooth finish. Plus, you'll have fun in the process. Here's some other things you'll need. Paint. We're using a paint and primer combination. Wagner Paint Easy for conditioning latex paint and creating a smooth flow. Drop cloths to protect the floor. Lightweight plastic sheeting and masking tape to protect walls and the ceiling from overspray. We also recommend wearing a mask and safety glasses anytime you're spraying paint. So let's get started. If you haven't installed your trim yet, painting it is easy because you won't have to mask any walls or bend and stoop while painting. Just lay it down horizontally on a pair of sawhorses, spray the trim, and install it once dry. If your trim has already been installed, you'll have a few more steps to do. Start by repairing any holes or dings with wood putty. Allow it to dry for the recommended time. You can also use a Wagner heat gun to speed up the process. When the putty is dry, sand the filled nail holes smooth using sandpaper. Then, lightly sand the rest of the trim to scuff up any gloss so the new paint will stick better. Finally, wipe away the dust and clean the wood thoroughly with a wet rag or tack cloth. Also, be sure to caulk any gaps between the walls and trim using latex caulking. Now it's time to prepare the room for painting. Grab your plastic masking and painter's tape and cover anything you don't want painted, including the walls and ceiling around the trim. Lay down drop cloths to protect your floor and any furniture that might still be in the room. Now for the fun part, spraying. As I mentioned, we're using the Wagner FLEXiO 3500 paint sprayer, which is great for a wide variety of projects, including painting trim. Your FLEXiO 3500 comes with two nozzles, an eye spray nozzle for broad surfaces, and a detail nozzle for fine finish work like painting trim. Spraying is much faster and easier than a brush. Plus, it'll give you a nice, smooth finish with no brush marks. Choose your favorite paint color and mix it with Wagner Paint Easy in your sprayer's material cup. Once you've adjusted the paint flow and airflow and tested your spray pattern on a piece of cardboard, you're ready to start painting. Our walls have already been painted an on-trend color, and we're painting our trim white to cover the old, dark stain. Start at one end of the trim and spray along its entire length. Keep the sprayer steady and about 6 inches away from the trim. Be sure to keep the tip of your sprayer parallel with the trim while you're spraying. Adjust your nozzle for up and down spraying or side to side. Wipe the spray tip periodically with a wet cloth to prevent paint buildup on the nozzle. It's so satisfying to see that color change. When you're done painting, remove all of the painter's tape and plastic while the paint is still slightly wet, so the tape won't pull off any trim paint. So, what do you think? Painted trim really pops and ties in nicely with the color of the walls. Plus, this was so fun that it didn't even feel like work. We hope you enjoyed this video and that it inspires you to paint your own trim. For more how-to videos and to see Wagner's complete line of sprayers and other painting products, visit WagnerSprayTech.com. Thanks for watching.